Seventh graders, lesson 4 or 5, we're gonna solve combination problems. We're talking about problem solving and solving problems that involve combinations. Like when you go into a restaurant and you've got some choices that you have to make, we're gonna talk about how many different choices you have when you're choosing some things, okay? Now, the first thing we're going to talk about, though, is solving combination problems to make pairs. Okay? There are two ways that we can make pairs to solve combination problems when you're pairing some things up. One way is to use a web diagram like this. Let's say that we had 5 teams, and they each need to play each other on a regular season schedule. Okay? One thing that we could do is use dots and lines, and each line between the dots represents a game. Okay. So A plays B, that's one game. B has to play C. C has to play D. D has to play E. E has to play A. And then count those segments, okay? But then A has to play C, D, and you know that A has already played E because that line is already there. Then B, they've already played C, but they have to play D and E, right? And C has already played D, but they have to play E. And then D has already played everyone. And E has already played everyone. How do you know? How do you know that that D and E have already played everyone? The line is already there. Right, you already drew that line. So then in that case, you just have to count the lines. Count the line segments. And you have all the pairs possible. Okay? Does that make sense? So how many pairs do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 pairs. Okay. There is another way to do this that is helpful for some people, and you can use this method if you want to, and that is to list the choices going across A, B, C, D, and E, and then list the choices going down A, B, C, D and E, and then pair them up and make what's called a rectangular array.
Yeah, this is what we did before.
Yeah, this is another way, is to make an array. Now, A can't play it themselves, so don't count that one, but A can play B, A can play C, D, E, and so on. And then B has already played A, but they can't play themselves. But they can play C, and so on. Okay? So we've done these before. This is another way to do it. All right? It is, this way might be easier for some people to draw it out this way. And this way may be easier for some people. Both of them can give you the right combinations by counting them up, okay? Now, if you have more than 2 choices, then the best way to do it is with a web. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let's look at problem number... example number one, I guess. on page 201. Mandy, Jim, Kaisha, Darren, Lynn, Chris, and Jen are friends. They want to take pictures of themselves with two people in each picture. Oh no, this is a two-person combination problem. Sorry. No, I'm thinking of the other one. Number three. Yeah, pizza toppings. So this is on page 203. Okay. With three or more choices we're talking about now. When you have to find three or more choices. So, you have pepperoni, mushrooms, onions, and green peppers. You have those choices. How many different pizzas can you make by using one, two, three, or four of the toppings? Okay? So, take a look at this. Start with one topping. So we have pepperoni. And this is one of your problems from your assignment today, so you may want to just copy this instead of doing your own thing right now. Page 203. Starting with pepperoni as a one-topping pizza, you could add mushrooms and onions and green peppers, right?
So you make it a square.
But then with pepperoni, you could just have a pepperoni and mushroom, pepperoni and onion, and a pepperoni and green pepper. Right? Then you could also do a pepperoni, mushroom, and green pepper, or a pepperoni, mushroom, and onion. And by making this web, you can connect all of those toppings.
Very nice.
Okay? Not really. Well, that's if you multiplied all of them, so 1 times 2 times 3 times 4, that's if you had to, have, see, 1 times 2 is 2, times 3 is 6, times 4 is 24, that's too many. Okay? That's too many tokens. You have to count them up.
I believe it's.
So you can, what you want to do is you want to add, how many one topping pizzas can you make?
Four.
Four. So start with that. Four one topping. Then how many two topping pizzas can you make? Pepperoni and mushroom, pepperoni and onion, pepperoni and green pepper, right? How many is that? Three. Then how many three topping pizzas can you make? You can make pepperoni, mushroom, and onion. Oops. Pepperoni, mushroom, and onion. Pepperoni, mushroom, and green pepper. Pepperoni, green pepper, and onion. Right?
Yeah.
So how many is that? Three, another three. And then, let's see. Do we have them all? Pepperoni, mushroom, onion. Pepperoni, onion, and... Well, we got pepperoni, mushroom, and onion. And then how many four topping pizzas can you make?
One.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? We can make more because what about just not starting with pepperoni? So we can make an onion, mushroom, and green pepper. Right? Well, we can make, with all of the other toppings, we can make an onion, mushroom, and green pepper. So then we would want to make, starting with onion, make a mushroom and green pepper. Okay? And then for two topping pizzas, we could also make just a green pepper and onion. So we can make four of these and so then three topping pizzas. We have pepperoni, mushroom and green pepper, pepperoni, mushroom and onion, onion, mushroom and green pepper, and pepperoni, onion and green pepper. So that's five. So how many is that?
14.
And then the four toppings. Okay, I need some more space here. And we're missing one. Does anyone know what we're missing? Onion and mushroom. Oh, for the two topping. Yes. The onion and mushroom. So just the onion and mushroom. So there we go. Now we have 15. No, it's 15. Okay. I said I need some more space. A better way to do this is to list them all like this. So we just have pepperoni, onion, mushroom, and green pepper. Okay? So that's four. Then make our two. Onion, pepperoni, mushroom, pepperoni, green pepper. Onion, mushroom, onion, green pepper, and then mushroom, green pepper. Okay? So that's our five. Wait, no, that's six. 1, 2, 3.
So we can only use each of those.
Then you can make the three topping pizzas.
Okay, so
pepperoni, onion, and mushroom. Pepperoni, mushroom, and green pepper. Green, mushroom, pepperoni, green pepper, and onion. And then onion, mushroom, and onion, green pepper, and so it should be four of those.
Down, you only use the less toppings.
Right.
So P, you get three.
Yep.
One, you get all three.
And then you've got your four toppings.
So you have four toppings, three toppings, two toppings.
Pepperoni, onion, mushroom, and green pepper.
Okay, so three.
Okay, so that makes your web. There's four one topping, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 two topping, 1, 2, 3, 4 three topping, and 1, 4 topping. Okay? Well, not, yeah, I mean, you can't do as many combos when you go down. All right? But The mistake that I tried to make is to do too much of it in my head the first time. When you really, you have to write it out so that you make sure that you have the combination that you need. Okay? Now, I want you to do number 4 and number 8. On page 203 for the rest of your assignment. Okay, number 4 and number 8. Okay?